सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम अखंड मंडलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुदेवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। I'll sing one bhajan of Bhagavan Shiva because Dakshinamurti Stotram is his stuti, Swami stuti. Manas bhajare guru charanam मानस भजरे गुरु चरणं दुस्तर भवसागर तरणं दुस्तर भवसागर तरणं। गुरु महाराज गुरु जय जय गुरु महाराज गुरु जय जय स्वामीनाथ सद्गुरु जय जय स्वामीनाथ सद्गुरु जय जय। ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः। ओम अरुणाचल शिव अरुणाचल शिव अरुणाचल शिव अरुण शिव अरुणाचल शिव अरुण शिव। ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः ओम शिवाय नमः ओम। हर हर नमः पार्वती पते हर हर महादेव। दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम फर्स्ट वर्स इन द ध्यान श्लोकास please repeat after me. Maunau vyakhya prakatita parabrahma tattvam yuvanam. Varishishtante vasadrushi ganaihi avrutam brahmanishtaihi. Acharyendram karakalita chinmudram anandarupam. Svatmaramam mudita vadanam dakshinamurti meede. Together. Maunavyakhya prakatita parabrahma tattvam yuvanam. Varshishtante vasadrushi ganaihi. Avrutam brahmanishtaihi. Acharyendram karakalita chinmudram anandarupam. Svatmaramam mudita vadanam. Dakshinamurti meede. Svatmaramam mudita vadanam. Dakshinamurti meede. Dakshinamurti Stotram written by Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji in the stuti of Bhagavan Shiva. But Bhagavan Shiva name in this stuti is called Dakshinamurti. In our last class, we have seen what do you mean by Stotram. Many meanings are there. Main purpose of Stotram is for our purification and for our joy. Stotram. And Dakshinamurti, Dakshina means it is one name of the Shuddha Buddhi. In Sanskritam it is there. Dakshina meaning Semushi Buddhi. That is a particular kind of intelligence which helps in the knowing of Brahman. Otherwise, with that buddhi, we can understand Brahmakara Vritti. Many people, we say, Swamiji, why they are not understanding this Brahma Vritti? Few people only understanding this Brahma Vritti. This is because of this pure intellect. The name of that pure intellect is called Semushi Buddhi, Dakshina. Dakshinamurti means Bhagavan Shiva, he has that buddhi. At the same time, he can bless us. If we don't have that kind of Shuddha buddhi, we also will fail in catching the knowledge of Brahman. So that Brahmakara vritti he gives in his teaching. Dakshina. Dakshina means another meaning also we have seen. Daksha. Daksha means he is very, very efficient in removal of our ignorance. And one more meaning also we have seen. Dakshina Amurti. In original, Swami is Amurti. Amurti means Nirakara Brahma. But he took a form that is called Dakshinamurti Guru Avataram. Dakshinamurtim Ide. Particularly, this Dakshinamurti is a Jnana Avatara of Bhagavan Shiva. Bhagavan Shiva, many avatars he has, Nataraja, Ityadi, Ityadi, so many. But this Dakshinamurti is Jnana Avatara of Bhagavan Shiva. Bhagavan Vishnu also has one Jnana Avatara. In Bhagavatam, that name is there. That is called Kapila Muni. Kapila Muni is the Jnana Avatara of Vishnu. Dakshinamurti is a Jnana Avatara of Bhagavan Shiva. To that Dakshinamurti, I am doing my namaskarams. Dakshinamurtim Ide. What is your Swami is doing, Dakshinamurti? Mauna Vyakhya ప్రకటిత పరబ్రహ్మతత్వం. పరబ్రహ్మతత్వం ప్రకటితం. ప్రకటిత మీన్స్ హీస్ టీచింగ్ అబౌట్ దట్ అబ్సల్యూట్ ట్రూత్, పరబ్రహ్మతత్వం. అండ్ మౌన వ్యాఖ్య, మౌన వ్యాఖ్య మీన్స్ ద సాధన ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ సైలెన్స్. హీ స్పీకింగ్ వెరీ లిటిల్ దిస్ అండ్ దట్ ఓన్లీ, బట్ మెజారిటీ భగవాన్ ద గురు ఈజ్ ఇన్ సైలెన్స్. మౌన వ్యాఖ్య ప్రకటిత పరబ్రహ్మ తత్వం. మై ఆచార్యజీ స్వామిజీ యూస్ టు సే, హౌ మెనీ వర్డ్స్ గురు షుడ్ స్పీక్, it depends on the level of the student. If the student is highly evolved, there is no need to talk much, because he himself already studied many scriptures, and a little hint is enough. Pujya Gurudev used to say, little hint is enough for the best student. And great masters, they can teach even from the silence itself. One incident, Mahatmas, they say, when Pujya Chandrasekhar Saraswati ji of Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham, he was the Acharya long ago. That time, our Gurudev, Swami Chinmayanand ji, he visited Chandrasekhar Kanchi Mata. Gurudev went inside. Mahaswamigal, he sat somewhere. Gurudev, he stood as it is, and that Mahatma, he sat on his chair as it is. You know, 3-5 minutes, they both were in silence. After that, Gurudev came out. And many disciples, they are observing what they both talk each other, but they did not talk anything. And after a few days, somebody asked Gurudev, what happened that day? He said, complete full, no need to talk. Anyo vacho vimunchata, Upanishad says. If it is completely full, then where the sound will come? I know that guru, this guru, Dakshinamurti guru, mauna vyakya prakatita parabrahma tattvam. And he is a yuva. Yuva means very young guru. Bhagavan, not only Bhagavan Shiva, and so many young gurus are there in our tradition. But like Sukadev, Bhagavata guru Sukadev, he is also very, very young, 16-17 year young boy. And then our Sanaka Sanandanadi rishis also, they are also young gurus. Here Dakshinamurti also, యువానం మౌన వ్యాఖ్య ప్రకటిత పరబ్రహ్మ తత్వం యువానం. దిస్ ఇస్ ద పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ గురు. ఇన్ అవర్ ప్రీవియస్ క్లాస్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్. అండ్ హౌ ద స్టూడెంట్స్, స్వామిజీ, స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆర్ వర్షిష్టాంతే వసదృషిగణై ఆవృతం బ్రహ్మనిష్టై. దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఆడ్జెక్టివ్స్ of the students. What are the adjectives, Swamiji? See the line. Students are Varshishtaha. Here, particularly in Dakshinamurti Stotram, the students are Varshishta. Varshishta means very, very elderly students they are. Guru is young, Yuvanam Guru. Whereas the students are very, very old students are there, Varshishtaha. And then Avrutam. Avrutam means they are surrounded by this Guru. Matlab Guru is there, around him, these old students, they sat. Varshishtaha Avrutam. And they have one more visheshan. That is called Varshishtaha Ante Vasat. If you see the line, Varshishtante Vasat. Varshishtaha means elderly people. Ante Vasat means there is a term called in our Upanishad that is called Ante Vasinaha. Antevasinaha means the students, they are staying with Guru. That state of studentship is called Antevasinam. For example, now our class is from 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock, let us take. 10 to 1, we all at one place, that is okay. But we cannot call it as Antevasi. Antevasi means day and night they should stay along with Guru. That is called Gurukula Vasinaha. Antevasinaha. In Prashnopanishad also it is there. All students, six students, they go to Guru and they ask Mahatma, we want to know about Brahma. And Guru says, right now I am not going to give. So what should we do? You have to stay 1 year in the ashram with me. With tapascharya and brahmacharyam, you have to stay in the ashram with me. After that, I will teach Brahman or whatever questions you ask. If I know, I will teach. That life is called Antevasinaha. In our terminology, we say it is called Gurukula Vasam. Guru and Shishyas both have to stay for a certain time in a particular place. Our Gurudev started Sandipni Sadhanalaya. It is called Antevasin. Antevasin means the students from all over the world, they should come. And they should stay with the Acharya for 2 years. No chutti for Acharya, no chutti for students. And why all the 2 years, master can understand the level of the student and student also can tune with the guru. That is called Antevasinaha. Here, the students are Antevasinaha. Antevasinaha means they are staying with Bhagavan Shiva only. Veda Manucharyo Antevasina Manushasti. In Veda, one sutra is there. If you want to know about Vedam, you should stay with Guru for certain time. That is needed. In Pooja Gurudev language, there is a tuning between Shishya and Guru. Then transformation of knowledge is very, very easy. So, Varshishtaha Antevasinaha. Students are Antevasina. And one more visheshanam they have, Varshishtante. Antevas Rushiganaihi. Students are not common lay people. They are all Rushiganaihi. They are all Rushi Muni people. In olden days, this Mumukshatvam, want to knowing about Brahman, it is not a common people's thali. After Vivekanandaji, little system changed. Actually, many, many ashramas, they don't teach also Brahma Jnana. They give Upasana, they give Karma, they give Ityadi, Ityadi. But if you ask Moksha Jnanam, then they say not now. You have to become so matured, so matured, so matured like that, you should be very exalted. These students also, Rishiganaha. Rishiganaha means they are very, very tapaschali. Many meanings are there for Rishi. Main meaning for Rishi is, Rishi means Kranta Darshinaha. Kranta Darshina means who can see beyond common people's sight. Generally, what we see is enjoyment, pleasure, pain. These are only we see. But this Kranta Darshi, he can see the Paramakalyanam. The students are that category students, Rishiganaha. And somewhere Bhagavan Shankaracharya, whom we can call Rishi, means he says he should not have three things. One is Maya Rahitam. Maya should not be there. Second one is called Kushakam. Kushakam means very, very narrow-mindedness. Third one is Shatha. Shatha means he is not willing to give. A man, if he doesn't have these three bad qualities, then we can call him as a Rishi. Maya, कुशकं शतबुद्धि नास्ति यस्य अस्ति सा ऋषिः, he can be called as a ऋषि. So that kind of ऋषिगणाः, great mahatma people are students. Krantadarshanah, very evolved sadhakas. That means they have done all preparatory things. They are well prepared to receive this Brahma Jnana. Very much qualified to attain Brahma Jnana. That students, Rishiganah. And one more qualification they have, Brahma Nishtaihi. Students, here not the Guru. Guru is Brahma Nishta, that is leave it. Students also, Bhagavan Shankaracharya is saying, they are Brahmanishtaihi. Brahmanishtaihi means not Nirguna Nirakara Brahmanishta. There are two meanings for Brahmanishta here particularly. The commentator says, one meaning for Veda is called Brahma. So Brahmanishtaihi means they are very well versed in scriptures. Students. They have so much faith in the scriptures. This is very much needed. If the student have faith in the guru and scripture, he will drop there only. Whatever Gita is saying, whatever Upanishad is saying, he has complete faith in that nishta is called Brahma Nishta. This is one meaning. Another meaning, they have a Brahma Nishta, but that Brahma is Saguna Brahma Nishta. Saguna Brahma Nishta means they are great upasakas. Students, they have done lot of upasana, 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 and they completely sattvika. Saguna Brahma Nishta Vidyardhi. Karma, upasana, japa, tapa, everything they have done. This is the qualification of the students. Varshishtante vasadrushiganaihi avrutam brahma nishtaihi. This kind of matured, evolved, prepared students are surrendered by our guru, Dakshinamurti. So, how is your Swami, Swamiji? He says he is addressing Dakshinamurti as in the third line. Acharya Indram. Our Sadguru Dakshinamurti is Acharya Indram. He is the king of all Acharyas. Bhagavan Shiva is not a common Acharya. Acharya Indram, great Guru, king of all Gurus, that is our Dakshinamurti, Acharya Indram. Generally, for a teacher, in our tradition, we use some particular names. For example, here, Bhagavan Shankaracharya used as Acharya. In the next verse, he will use Guru. These are all indicate one only, that is teacher. I know. We also use, he is the Acharya of Chinmaya Mission, he is the Acharya of Ramakrishna Mission. The main translation is, he is a teacher in Chinmaya Mission. He is a teacher in Ramakrishna Mission. This is the meaning. But in Sanskritam, there is a beautiful meaning for Acharya. This word Acharya, it is coined from a dhatu called Chi. Chi means Chinoti. Chinoti means who can collect, who can gather. So Acharya means who can collect, who can gather all the meanings of the scriptures. Deep, deep meanings. What it is indicating, what it is saying, all the scriptural knowledge he should have. That person we can call as Acharya. Chinoti. Chinoti means who can collect. That means he is well versed, well studied all the scriptures. He has complete knowledge before catering to the students. This is one meaning for Acharya. And another meaning also there for Acharya, that is called Acharet Sthapayan Api. Some traditions are coming from the time. And they are called Acharana. Acharana means, for example, class timing sharp at 10 o'clock. So sharp at 10 o'clock. The teacher, he should establish that discipline. Who establishes that discipline, he can be called as Acharya. Sthapayitva. Students must know. Oh, 6:30 ho gaya, Swamiji is coming. They used to say in our Pooja Gurudev Jnana Yajnas, if Pooja Gurudev starts Omkaram on the dais, it means it is exactly 6:30 p.m. Indian time. That discipline he used to maintain. Sthapayitva means he should establish that discipline. That person also called as Acharya. And one more meaning is there. He not only instructions, he should follow also. Acharati api. The master, the teacher, whatever he is saying, whatever he is teaching, he should also follow. So, this man is called Acharya. First meaning is very well versed. Second meaning is he should establish the discipline. Third meaning is he should follow the discipline. That guru we call as Acharya. Acharya means he is a role model for all the student kingdom. In study, in teaching, everything he should be a role model. Then people can inspire in study and practice at the same time in preaching and following also. He is our role model. Acharya Indram. Indram means Bhagavan Shiva is what to talk of him. He is the king of all gurus. Acharya Indram. And one more. Karakalita Chinmudram. Here Dakshinamurti. He is having one posture, one mudra. That mudra is called Chin Mudra. Chin Mudra means Jnana Mudra. Chit means Jnana, Mudra means posture. Always Bhagavan Shiva, he will have one posture in his hand, Karakalita. Karakalita means in his hand, always he have one mudra. That is called Chin Mudra, Jnana Mudra. Swamiji, what is this Chin Mudra, Swami? Actually, in our Sampradaya, there is a Mudra Shastra also there. If you see the Bharatanatyam Ityadi people, they whatever they want to express, they express with mudras only. This is Chandra, this is Surya, this is water, this is air, everything mudra, mudra only. Bhagavan Shiva also has one mudra, that is called Chin Mudra, Jnana Mudra. Jnana Mudra means this is called Jnana Mudra, they say. Our index finger and thumb finger, if you join these two, this mudra in our hand is called Chin Mudra. Shivji, always he keeps this Chin Mudra and he meditates. If you see his posture, pictures and anything, he closes these two and he meditates on Brahman. And this is not anything artificial. You know, because he is a Jnana Rupi, always by itself they close each other. And many, many commentators, they say, this index finger is an indication for our Jeevahood. Index finger is an indication for Jeevahood. This thumb is an indication for Brahma Stiti. When our ego merges into that Brahma, that is called Chin Mudra. Who can do? Who can merge these two? Jnanam can do. That's why this mudra is called Jnana Mudra, Chin Mudra. Otherwise, always this Jiva with these three bodies, gross body, subtle body, and causal body, and is a Jiva always says you, 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 you. Plurality, 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 everywhere plurality. This is the job of Jiva. because he is associated with these three bodies. So the knowledge should separate this ego and connect this ego with Brahma, then it will know, it will not make any noise. It will be in meditation with Brahma. That is called Chinmudra. Swami Karakalita Chinmudram. His karam, his hand, always with this Chinmudra. And this thumb, you know, this is the support for all the fingers. This is the basement for all the fingers. If you remove this thumb, they cannot work. So Brahman is like that. For all the three bodies and the jivahood, Brahman is support. This jiva, he should leave the three bodies identification, and with the help of knowledge, he should connect with Brahma. That is called Chinmudra, Karakalita Chinmudra. Ananda Rupam. And the Rupam of Guru is nothing other than bliss. Because he is Brahma. Brahma is none other than complete Purna Ananda Swarupam. That's why his Rupam itself Anandam. Not because of anything. Ananda Rupam. Svatmaramam Muditavadanam Dakshinamurti Nide. To that kind of Svatmarama Dakshinamurti, I am doing my salutations. Maunavyakya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam Varishishtante Vasadrushiganaihi Avrutam Brahma Nishtaihi Acharyendram Karakalita Chinmudram Ananda Rupam Swatma Ramam Mudita Vadanam Dakshinamurtim Ide. I am doing my namaskar to that Guru, Dakshinamurti. Now, second verse. Swamiji, students are ready. Guru is also ready. Where they are teaching? In Santipini Sadhanalaya or where? In which hall? So Bhagavan Shankaracharya is saying in the second verse, Vatavitapi samipe bhumi bhage nishannam. Sakala munijananam jnana dataram arat. Tribhuvana guru misham dakshinamurti devam. Janana marana dukha cheda daksham namami. Together. Vatavitapi samipe bhumi bhage nishannam. Sakala muni jananam jnana dataram arat. Tribhuvana guru misham dakshinamurti devam. Janana marana dukha cheda daksham namami. Namami. Because many times we are told, if you want to open any slokam, we have to catch the verb. Here the verb is namami. Namami means I am doing my salutations. Namami. Whom you are doing namaskaram? Tribhuvana guru misham dakshinamurti devam. I am doing my namaskaram to dakshinamurti devam. My dakshinamurti is not a human being. Then who is he? Devam. Devam means Dyotanat iti devaha. In Sanskrit they say. Dyotanat means he is very, very brilliant. Prakasha Rupi. Which Prakasham Swamiji? Jnana Prakasha Rupi Sadguru. Dakshinamurti Devam. Oh. Dyotanat. This Dakshinamurti Deva Tribhuvana Gurum. Is not common guru, sir. My guru is Tribhuvana Guru. Tribhuvana Guru means he is the guru of all three worlds. They say Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, and Suvarloka. These three are one group. In Gayatri Mantra also we chant Om Bhur Bhuva Suvaha Tat Savitruvarenyam. Why not other four, Swamiji? Actually, upper they say seven worlds are there. Till three only why they chant, other four why they leave? Because Mahatma say the upper four lokas, the upper four lokas, they cannot be called as a lokas because they are their tapasic people, maha people, they stay, they are not considered as a beings like us. Whereas this Bhuloka, Bhuvaloka, Subhaloka, Swargaloka people, they have Janma, they have death, they have sadhana, they have to reach a particular point. So these three worlds are one group. Bhuhu, Bhuvaha, Subhaha. Dakshinamurti, Sadguru, Tribhuvana Guru Misam. He is the guru of three worlds. Actually, that is not a correct phrase. We should say Bhagavan Shiva is a Jagat Guru. Is the guru of the entire world, not for Hindus, not for someone, not for some Jagat Guru. By the way, Pooja Guruji always used to say one joke regarding this word Jagat Guru. One day, few group of people, set of people, they are coming, you know, Jagat Guru ki jai, Jagat Guru ki jai, Jagat Guru ki jai. And the man who is passing on the road, he thought some Jagat Guru is coming from Kanchi or Srungeri somewhere. He has seen one common guru is there, an ordinary guru. And he stopped the rally and he said, why are you calling this guru as Jagat Guru? He is not Jagat Guru. Then the follower said, no. This guru has one student. One student on. His name is Jagat. So he is the guru of that student Jagat. That's why we are calling him as a Jagat Guru. Our Shankara is not that kind of Jagat Guru. Jagat Guru means he is the guru of gurus, guru of the entire world. Tribhuvana Guru Misham. Bhagavan is Tribhuvana Guru. As I said, in the previous verse for teacher, Bhagavan Shankaracharya used one word called Acharya, Acharyendram there. Here he used one word that is called Guru here. Tribhuvana Gurum, Isham. And we also use Guru, 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 Guru. Swamiji, actually there are so many meanings for Guru. Entire our Guru Stotram is none other than Guru Stuti on. But mainly, our teachers, they give three meanings for Guru, whom we can call Guru. First meaning is, Gurutvat Atishayatvat Guruhu. This is the definition for Guru. Why we call him Guru, you know, Gurutvat. Gurutvat means he is very, very heavy. His knowledge is heavy. His personality is very heavy. He will not be moved by any kind of ordinary, worldly, common things. His establishment in a big vastu. That's why we can call him as Guru. Gurutvat means he is very, very heavy. That's why many people, they say, if you want to understand Bhagavan, it is okay. If you try hard, you can understand Bhagavan. But you cannot understand what is my Guru. He is so deep, so deep, so deep. His teaching, his sight, his walking, everything has its own great significance. That's why getting Guru is difficult. Getting God is easy. That deep personality, heavy personality is Guru. This is one meaning. Garima, they call Garima means very, very heavy. you cannot comprehend, you cannot frame guru. Second meaning is for guru, guhyan ardan rauti ghoshayati. There are two words in the guru aina. One is called gu. Gu means guhyan ardan. Guhyan ardan means very, very secret meanings, deep meanings. Ghoshayati, ru means ghoshayati, means he can explain. If there is no guru, we cannot understand what is there in Upanishad. Bhagavan Shankaracharya, he sat there and he explained every mantra, every word, what is the significance, what it indicates. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult to fathom them. Simply, Upanishad, it says, Tattvamasi, you are that. How can it both together? To explain that Tattvamasi, Bhagavan Shankaracharya written almost 100 books. Not 100 paragraphs. How this Jiva can be Ishvara? But Upanishad is saying both are same. Guhyan Ardhan, most sacred, most deep, deep, deep meanings also he can explain. That is called Guru, another meaning. And third meaning they say, Girati Nigarati, means who can swallow our ignorance. Many people, they say, Swamiji, why should we stay with Guru? We will stay in our house. No, no, no. Guru slowly observes us. And with his Mahima, he can remove all our drawbacks. In a time, we will come to know, I am also become a sadhaka. How it has happened? I thought I am a fool. I thought I am not fit for the spirituality. Now I am comfortable. Slowly we also grow, we also grow, we also. That clarity he can give. He will eat our ignorance, he will eat our impurities, and he will clear the spiritual path. And the final meaning for Guru is Grunnati Upadishati. Upadishati means the main job of Guru is teaching. Upades. He has to teach. Our Gurudev Swami Chinmayananji is a role model in this teaching. He started in, for example, 1951, this profession or this job of teaching. Of Gita and Upanishad, all the spiritual texts, you know. Till 1993, meaning 42 years, every day he used to teach three classes. Whether his age is 76, 75, or 60, or something else. Whether the land is America, or Europe, or corner of India. Any time ready to teach. This should be the great quality of the teacher. He should not say, you know, I am not well now, or I am not comfortable with you people. Whoever comes, great teacher, Mahan teacher is our Pujya Gurudev. As we said, they used to say, Brahma Jnanam cannot be catered to everyone. There should be some qualification to the student. But Gurudev said, no. I will sit in the marketplace only. I will teach. Bhagavan, he will take care. Whoever qualified, whoever wants to listen, let them. Thousands of people used to come and listen. And they used to understand this knowledge. Hooray, what a miracle it is. We thought our Sampradaya, our Siddhanta, our book, they are not for working class. But Gurudev said, no, this is life science. This Vedanta is nothing other than science of our own life. Everybody should know it because everyone is Brahman. Knowing Brahman is their birthright. This is called Upadesh. So that kind of Gurum Isham, that Bhagavat Swarupa Sadguru, I am doing my Namaskar. And what will your Guru do? Janana Marana Dukkha Cheda Daksham. He is very, very efficient in Dukkha Chedam. Dukkha Chedam means in he will cut asunder all our sorrows. Before going to the Guru, of course, we are all the time crying. But after reaching the Guru, after his Upadesha, all the Dukkha should go away. Janana Marana Dukkha Cheda Daksham Sadgurum. And Dukkha begins with Jananam and ends with Maranam. In between also, we will have so many experiences. All experiences are common thing is Dukkham, Dukkham, Dukkham. Everything is Dukkham only. Gurudev always used to say, when we born in the world, we also cry and our mother also will cry. And slowly, one after another, so many complaints we face. And to get rid of that dukkham, we will take another one. That also gives sorrow and we take another one. Body also continuously gives pains. Mind also continuously will give pains. Intellect, of course, it will give pain on. Pain. Everything is dukkhamayam jagat. Gautama Buddha says the one and only truth in the world is sorrow. You may say this and that. He says no. One and only truth in the world is sorrow. If you want to get rid of that sorrow, surrender to Bhagavan. Janana marana dukkha cheda daksham namami. To that kind of Dakshinamurti Bhagavan, Sadguru. So the main job of the Guru here, you please understand. He will remove our sorrows. He will teach the supreme knowledge. With that we can be Ananda Rupi Sada, always. This is the main job of the teacher. And the power of knowledge, you know, actually, this is the only one thing which can help in our progress is Jnanam. That Jnanam, the address, the care of address for the knowledge is Sadguru. To that Sadguru, I am doing my Namaskaram. And where they are all sat, Swamiji, Vatavitapi Samipe Bhumi Bhage Nishannam. This Guru and the students, Nishannam. Nishanna means they seated. Where they seated? Bhumi Bhage. Bhumi Bhage means on floor. Actually, in Upanishads also they said, Chairastam is not allowed. Student should sit near the Guru and below the Guru. It is a mark, you know, because knowledge should flow from higher point to lower point. So that attitude students should maintain. We can sit in sofa, we can sit in chair, that is okay. But here, dekho, students are very old, very great, because Rishiganaihi Brahmanishtaihi. Even though they sat at the feet of the Guru on the floor, on the ground. Bhumi Bhage Nishannam. Nishannam means they all seated on the ground. Where, Swamiji? Vatavitapi Samipe. Vatavitapi Samipe means under a banyan tree. If you see the Dakshinamurti picture also, Dakshinamurti, he sits. Around him, all the Rishiganas, they sit. And they are all under one banyan tree. In Tulsi Ramayana also, it is explained, Bhagavan Shiva always wants to sit under banyan tree. Why, Swamiji? He says, Vata Viswasaha. This Vata Vruksha is a representative for Shraddha. Bhagavan Shiva, he loves Shraddha very much. Our Acharyaji used to say, particularly in this Vedanta Vidya, the main role is faith. Gita also says, Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. If you want knowledge, you should be Shraddhavan. It takes so much time. On the way, so many confusions will come. Whether my guru is all right or not. Whether the scriptures are all right or not. Whether I am all right or not. Some sadhakas, they get that confusion also. Whether I am going okay. Because many people are thinking, he is a pagal, mad fellow. After saying that, listening that, he also come to know whether I am a pagal or okay. So faith will shake, you know, many times. So this Vatavruksha, that Vatavruksha size faith we should have. Until and unless I am not going to leave my guru, I am not going to leave my study, I am not going to leave my sadhana. That firm faith, strong faith is called Vatavruksha. And by the way, our Mahatmas, they say, some trees represent some kind of gunam. For example, as we have seen, Vatavruksha is for faith, aina. Mango tree, they say, mango tree is a tree of glamour. That's why Madana Dev, he always stays on mango tree only. His tree is mango tree. Guru's tree is this Vatavruksha. At the same time, Arjuna Vruksha, if you have seen, Arjuna Vruksha, they say it is very straightforward. Ruju Marga. Arjuna Vruksha. This way, many trees, they have some particular qualities. Here, Vatavruksha. Vatavitapi Samipe, Bhumi Bhage Nishannam. All the students and teacher, they are all with faith. At the same time, teacher also should have in the faith. He will study. Today, okay, he is little this and that, teda meda. Slowly, he will get in tune with the studies. And students also should faith on guru and scriptures and sadhana and on himself and God and everything. Then only that spiritual journey we can enjoy. Sakala munijananam jnanadataram arat. So under this Vatavruksha, Bhagavan Shiva is the teacher, very young, bright, sharp, anandarupi. And all the Rishi Muni Gana, they are well-versed, advanced seekers, they sat. Here what is happening? Jnana Dataram, Bhagavan Shiva, he is giving knowledge. Dataram means he is doing Danam. Which Danam, Swamiji? Jnana Danam. Jnana Dataram. To whom, Swamiji, he is giving Sakala Munijananam. To all the Munijana, all the students, he is giving knowledge. And Arat means the students, they came by themselves. This is one more very, very important point. Guru is very, very capable. But the student should have that jignasa. I want to know. I want to study. I want to learn. Then only he will approach that guru and with Shraddha, Bhakti, everything he will learn. That is called Arat. Arat means they came by themselves. Sakala munijananam jnanadataram arat. To that people, Bhagavan Shankara, he is ready to teach this knowledge. Now, the authors of this stuti, this picture is there. You can also visualize, there is a big Vatavruksha. Bhagavan Shiva is there as Dakshinamurti Guru, and all the students are there. And here the next sloka it is saying, Arre, 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 see the wonder. You please visualize what is happening there. Then we also see what is happening there. He is saying, Chitram Vatataror Mungle. Vruddha Sishya Gurur Yuva. Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam. Sishyastu Chinna Samshayaha. Together. Chitram Vatataror Mule Vruddha Sishya Gurur Yuva Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Sishyastu Chinna Samshayaha. Aha. Chitram. Chitram means Vichitram. It is a wonder, wonder, wonder. Where's our Vatataror Mule? Vatataror Mule means under that banyan tree, there is a wonder. What is that wonder? Vruddhaha Sishyaha. Guruhu Yuva. This is the first two wonder. Sishyas are very, very vruddhas. With long beard, long white beard, and old students are there with danda, kamandal and everything. Vruddhaha Sishya. Guruhu Yuva. And the guru is very, very young, teenage boy. He is shining like a Sakshat Brahma. Actually, it should be reverse. Aina? Guru should be with white, long beard and everything, and Shishya should be very young and fresh and new. But in Dakshinamurti case, reverse. Shishyas are very, very old, and Guru is very yuva. Because, you know, these Shishyas, these Mahatmas, they have spent a whole lifetime with karma and upasana. They stuck there. Because there is a lot of sattvic enjoyment. They are also spiritual practices only. Karma and upasana. They used to do lot of karma, lot of upasana, lot of karma, lot of upasana. By that they become old. And in study of scriptures and everything. But to get jignasa, they took this much time. Jignasa means they want to the ultimate goal of life. Purna purushardham, that is called moksha purushardham. The vasana for moksha, to get that vasana for moksha, they have to spend the whole life. That's why shishyas will become very, very old. Vruddhaha, Shishyaha, all beard, white end, and they become very old. They are like a ripened fruits. Whereas this guru is Bhagavan Shiva. He knew the value of knowledge. That's why in the early only he can understand, he understood what is Brahman, and he realized that Brahman is me. I am not this body, mind, intellect, or the worldly relations. That is the greatness of Bhagavan Shiva. So as an young boy only, he understood the power of knowledge and greatness of knowledge. He did not spend his time in karma and upasana. That's why Guru is Yuva and Shishyas are very, very old. This is one wonder. Chitram Vatataror Mule Vruddha Shishya Guru Yuva. And one more wonder is there. That is called Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam. Generally, All the gurus are nice orators. They have to speak left and right. Otherwise, you know, people, they say, ah, my guru is not that big guru. Why? Guru means he should be very eloquent and this and that, you know. But here, gurostu maunam vyakhyanam. His vyakhya is almost silence. Little here and there, he is speaking little. Otherwise, he is completely maunam. So is it working, Swamiji? Shishyastu chinna samsayaha. With that maunam only, all the samsayas of the shishyas are become chinna. Chinna means they are getting cleared. That capable guru, this guru. Gurostu maunam vyakhyanam, shishyastu chinna samsayaha. Actually, one after another, shishyas are going away from the teaching. It is said. Many people ask why they are going away. Because all their doubts are clarified. Not food is bad, bed is very rough, not that way. Water is very cold, not that way they are not leaving the guru. All the shishyas are leaving the guru because whatever the doubts they have, all doubts are clarified with his maunam only. This is another wonder. Gurostu maunam vyakhyanam, shishyastu chinna samsayaha, chidyante sarvasamsayaha, vidyante hrudaya grandihi, kshiyante chasya karmani, yasmin drushte paravare. Upanishad say. So that way, this is a wonder under that banyan tree. Dakshinamurti setup is happening. Chitram vatataror mule, Vriddha Shishya Gurur Yuva. Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Shishyastu Chinna Samshayaha. This way both are there. In the next class, what they are doing, we will see. We will chant Bhagavan Shiva name for 1 minute. Then we will conclude our class. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Om Purnamadha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamiva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namah.